Chief Ashley Williams of the 212. You the one in charge here, sir?
Are you wounded, Williams?
A few scrapes and burns. Nothing serious. The others weren't so lucky. Oh, man. We were patrolling the perimeter when the attack hit. We tried to get off a distress call, but they cut off our communications. I've been fighting for my life ever since.
Where's the rest of your squad?
We tried to double back to the beacon, but we walked into an ambush. I don't think any of the others... I think I'm the only one left.
This isn't your fault, Williams. You couldn't have done anything to save them.
Yes, sir. We held our position as long as we could, until the Geth overwhelmed us.
The Geth haven't been seen outside the Vale in nearly 200 years. Why are they here now?
They must have come for the beacon. The dig site is close, just over that rise. It might still be there.
We could use your help, Williams.
Aye, aye, sir. It's time for payback.
Describe what happened leading up to the attack.
We were sent out a couple of nights ago from the main colony to secure the area. Seemed like a routine patrol, until the Geth hit us. We never knew they were coming.
Tell me everything you know about the beacon.
They were doing some digging out here to extend the monorail and expand the colony. A few weeks ago, they unearthed some Prothean ruins, and the beacon. Suddenly, every scientific expert in the colony was interested. That's when they brought us in to secure the site. I don't know much about the beacon itself, but I heard one of the researchers say this could be the biggest scientific discovery of the century.
What happened to the researchers at the dig site?
I don't know. They set up camp near the beacon. The 232 was with them. Maybe their unit fared better than mine.
What else do you know about the Geth?
Just what I remember from history class back in school. They're synthetics, non-organic life forms with limited AI programming, created by the Quarians a few centuries ago. They were supposed to be a source of cheap labor, but ended up turning on the Quarians and drove them into exile. Well, after that, they just kind of disappeared behind the Perseus Vale. Nobody's really heard much from them since.
Move out.
This is the dig site. The beacon was right here and must have been moved.
By who? Our side or the Geth?
Hard to say. Maybe we'll know more after we check out the research camp.
You think anyone got out of here alive?
If they were lucky. Maybe hiding up in the camp. It's just on the top of this ridge, up the ramps.
We're just a bunch of farmers. These guys are soldiers. Maybe we should give them the stuff.
Jeez, Blake, you gotta learn when to shut up.
If there's something you're not telling me...
Some guys at the spaceport were running a small smuggling ring. Nothing major. In exchange for a cut of the profits, we let them store packages in our sheds.
You greedy bastard. You weren't running for your life. You were running to check on your merchandise.
No, it's not like that. I just knew there were some packages here, something we could use. I found a pistol. Figured it would come in handy if those things came back. But you'll probably get more use out of it than we will.
I'm only gonna ask this once. Think long and hard before you lie to me again. Are you sure all you've got is one lousy pistol?
Wait. I just remembered. I just had it in my pocket. Might as well take that too. That's everything, really.
Who's your contact at the spaceport, Cole? What's his name?
He's not a bad guy. I don't want to get him in trouble. Besides, I'm not a snitch.
Would you rather be a snitch or a corpse?
Powell. His name's Powell.
No honor among thieves.
That's all I know, really. So let's try to keep things friendly from here on in, okay?
Fox.
Sometimes I need a nap to get through my shift. I sneak off behind the crates to grab 40 winks where the supervisor can't find.
You survived because you're lazy?
Tell me about the Geth attack.
It was quick. One minute the ship was descending, the next, those Geth were swarming over the platform, thousands of them. They must have been inside that mothership. They shot anything that moved. It was a massacre.
You're Cole's contact here on the docks. For the smuggling ring.
What? No! I mean, what does it matter now? So I'm a smuggler, who cares? My supervisor's dead, the entire crew's dead. Doesn't matter now, does it?
Anything hidden nearby that we could use against the Geth?
A shipment of grenades came through last week. Nobody notices if a few small pieces go missing from the military orders.
You greedy son of a bitch. We're out here trying to protect your sorry ass, and all you can think about is how you can rip us off?
I never thought you'd actually need those grenades. Who'd want to attack Eden Prime? We're just a bunch of farmers. How was I supposed to know?
Normandy, the beacon is secure.
This is amazing. Actual working Prothean technology. Unbelievable.
It wasn't doing anything like that when they dug it up. Something must have activated it.
Roger, Normandy. Standing by.
No, don't touch him! He's too dangerous!
Doctor! Dr. Chakwas! I think he's waking up.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
Minor throbbing. Nothing serious. How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I must have triggered some kind of security field when I approached it. You had to push me out of the way.
You had no way to know what would happen.
Actually, we don't even know if that's what set it off. Unfortunately, we'll never get the chance to find out.
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. The blast knocked you cold. The lieutenant and I carried you back here to the ship.
I appreciate it.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. The crew could use some good news after what happened to Jenkins.
Jenkins was a valuable part of this crew.
Part of me feels guilty over what happened. If Jenkins was still alive, I might not be here.
You're a good soldier, Williams. You belong on the Normandy.
Thanks, Commander. I appreciate that.
Things were pretty rough down there. Are you okay?
I've seen friends die before. Comes with being a Marine. But to see my whole unit wiped out. And you never get used to seeing dead civilians. But things would have been a lot worse if you hadn't shown up.
We couldn't have done it without you, Williams.
Thanks, Commander. I have to admit, I was a little worried about being assigned to the Normandy. It's nice when someone makes you feel welcome.
I think you're gonna fit in here just fine, Williams.
Thanks, Commander. Look at the size of that ship!
The Ascension, flagship of the Citadel Fleet.
Well, size isn't everything.
Why so touchy, Joker?
I'm just saying, you need firepower too.
Look at that monster! Its main gun could rip through the barriers in any ship in the Alliance fleet.
Good thing it's on our side, then.
I can't believe the Council ignored all the evidence against Saren.
Saren's one of their best operatives. It's only natural they take his word over ours.
Oh, so now we just chase leads while this smug Turian runs around with his Geth troopers.
That's politics, Chief.
I hate politics.
Big place.
That your professional opinion, sir?
This isn't a station. It's a city.
There must be millions here. It can't be possible to track everyone coming and going.
This makes Jump Zero look like a port-a-john, and it's the largest deep space station the Alliance has.
Jump Zero is big, but this is a whole nother scale. Look at the ward arms. How do they keep all that mass from flying apart?
The Council represents more races than I thought. No wonder they're careful with newcomers.
They probably just want to keep everything running. It has to be hard keeping all these cultures working together.
Or maybe they just don't like humans.
Why not? We've got oceans, beautiful women, this emotion called love. According to the old vids, we have everything they want.
If you expect to get me in a tinfoil miniskirt and thigh-high boots, I want dinner first. Sir.
That will be enough, Chief.
At ease, Lieutenant. I can't see her in a skirt anyway.
Damn straight you can't.
Ready to move out, sir.
Paired you well for your duties, Gunnery Chief?
Trying to take down a rogue Spectre and his army of synthetics? No, they didn't cover this in basic.
Prime.
Wait, the 212? Your wife was Serviceman Nirali Bhatia. I'm Gunnery Chief Ashley Williams. I served in her unit.
Chief Williams, it is a pleasure. Nirali spoke of you with great respect.
I'm so sorry for your loss, Mr. Bhatia. Nirali was a good woman. What can we do for you?
But it may bring me peace. Goodbye, Commander.
Samesh, I don't know if this helps, but your wife... Nirali loved you very much. She missed your cooking, and she played recordings of you every night before she went to sleep.
I know, Miss Williams. But thank you. It's nice to hear it again.
Commander, you have a minute to talk?
I keep an open door policy. If you have any concerns, lay them on me.
All right. I know things are different aboard the Normandy, but I'm concerned about the aliens, Vakarian and Rex. With all due respect, Commander, should they have full access to the ship?
They may not serve the Alliance, Chief, but they're allies. At least as far as Saren goes.
This is the most advanced ship in the Alliance Navy. I don't think we should give them free rein to poke around the vital systems. Engines, sensors, weapons.
You don't trust the Alliance's allies?
I'm not sure I'd call the Council races allies. We, humanity, I mean, have to learn to rely on ourselves.
Standing up for ourselves doesn't mean standing alone.
I don't think we should turn down allies. I just think we shouldn't bet everything on them staying allies. As noble as the council members seem now, if their backs are against the wall, they'll abandon us.
I don't see that as inevitable.
Look, if you're fighting a bear and the only way for you to survive is to sick your dog on it and run, you'll do it. As much as you love your dog, it isn't human. It's not racism, not really. Members of their species will always be more important to them than humans are.
These seem like deeply held beliefs, Williams. What made you think this way?
My family's defended the Alliance since it was founded. My father, grandfather, great-grandmother, they all picked up a rifle and swore the oath of service. I guess we just tend to think of Earth's interests as our own.
I come from a military family, too. My parents were both Navy. Anybody in your family we might know?
Couldn't say, Commander. We probably have a lot in common. You join up to carry on the tradition?
No. The future of humanity is out here. There's so much we haven't seen yet.
Yeah. I still remember my first field exercise on Titan. When we hit mud, the reality hit me. I'm the first person who ever stood here. Then my drill instructor kicked me in the ass. I went face first into the muck. He spent the next 5 minutes chewing me out for gold breaking.
Don't tell me you had Gunny Ellison. He's the only one I know who uses that word to describe shirking duty.
Oh, Lord. You went to the Makapog boot camp, too? Yeah. Gunny Ellison's still reaming out recruits down there, kicking ass and using words like inveigle and pusillanimous.
It doesn't sound like you've worked with aliens before.
No, sir. Mainly I've been groundside, part of the surface garrison forces. I did get a rotation on a space station for training. Every Marine a rifleman, every rifleman ZG certified.
That's odd. Your record is spotless and your technical scores are exemplary. You should be serving with the fleet.
Anyway, that's why I haven't served with many aliens, Commander.
All right. I can see where your concerns are coming from, Williams. But this is a multilateral mission. You're going to have to work with aliens, like it or not.
It won't be a problem, Commander. You say jump, I say how high. You tell me to kiss a Turian, I'll ask which cheek.
I don't think kissing Turians will be necessary.
You never know, Commander.
We'll talk later, Williams.
Looking forward to it, sir.
Oh, before I go, you said you're serving with Commander Shepard now? We saw him on the news here. He's cute. Later, sis.
Tell me you didn't hear that.
Afraid I did.
Oh, shoot me now. One of my sisters. That's Sarah, the youngest. What's up? You didn't come by to eavesdrop on family mail.
Your family seems to be important to you.
Yeah, we've always been close. Me and my sisters especially. With Dad on duty so much, I had to help Mom raise them.
Did your father serve with the fleet?
Yeah, took any crap posting he could get that offered space time. You know what? He worked his ass off trying to get recognized, but he never made it above serviceman third class. He was real proud when I met Chief. First thing he did was salute.
What about your mother? You haven't mentioned her.
You must know what military wives are like. Strong because they have to be, able to raise kids while Dad's away on a 6-month cruise. She has a degree in planetary geology. She and Dad both wanted to see new worlds. She gave up her career to raise us, though.
Where did you grow up?
All over. Same as you, I expect. We transferred a half a dozen times before I finished grade school. You go where personnel command sends you, right? I guess that's why I'm so tight with my sisters. We'd have to leave all our friends every 2 or 3 years.
You have more than one sister? Sounds like a big family.
Yeah, I'm the oldest, then Abby, then Lynn. Sarah's the youngest. She's still in high school. With 4 girls, Dad used to say he felt more outnumbered at home than on maneuvers.
I was an only child, but I get the idea. At least one of my parents was always on duty.
Yeah, military families, eh? With schedules like that, it's a wonder we ever have kids anymore. Things were tense between Sarah and me for a while. Then we bonded.
Sounds like a story. Feel like sharing?
Sarah got herself a boyfriend who wanted to go faster than she did. Mike. I didn't think he was a bad kid, just pushy. Lynn would send me these worried vidmails, and I'd tell her to relax.
Where were you when this was going on?
I was on active duty. Sarah's graduating high school this year. This was only a couple of years back. They were on Amaterasu. At the time, I was assigned to Chernobyl. Same cluster, but a dozen LY away. Close enough to talk regularly, too far to make it back in an emergency. I couldn't afford a fast packet flight.
If he really liked her, he wouldn't be pushy.
Yeah, of course. If he didn't ask at all, I'd wonder if he thought Sarah was ugly. Damned if you do, damned if you don't. Mike thought they'd go for a romantic walk in the woods, because he figured it was past time they did the deed. She levered Mike face first into a tree and left. Didn't have a scratch on her. Good thing Mom and Dad had us all learn some kind of self-defense. I took emergency leave and walked Sarah to school for a few days.
You said all of your sisters learned self-defense?
Lynn did pistol practice, but didn't like it. She's kind of nervous. Sarah took Aikido. Abby decided to learn the sword. She always was a little weird. Likes big skirts and tops you have to tie her into. They do great things to her figure, though.
So, what did you learn?
One of Dad's friends taught me Marine hand-to-hand.
You traveled all the way home to walk your sister to school.
It was only a dozen light years. Like a day's cruise. It's not like I was going to Earth or something. My last day out, Mike was waiting for us. Sarah had told her friends, so everyone at school knew what he did. He wasn't happy. I wanted to snap him in half, but Sarah gave me this look, this let me handle it, I need to do this alone look. She kept her cool, God bless her, as he screamed in her face. She just let him vent. Then he tried to punch her. I swear, she just flowed around him. Next thing I knew, he's face down on the sidewalk, and there's blood everywhere.
That's unbelievable. Sarah must be as good as you.
Better. I'm more or less a straight-up puncher. When he swung, she wasn't there anymore, and he fell. She helped him stop the bleeding and had me call an ambulance. She told the paramedics he fell. Before they took him to the hospital, Mike touched Sarah's arm. I thought he was gonna end up on the ground again. But he hung his head, whispered, "I'm sorry," and started crying. And she hugged him. The Williams women are a decisive bunch, Commander. We do things when we're ready. Not before, not after.
Your sister's something else. But you didn't mention your father at all. Was he on deployment?
Dad always wanted to serve in space, but he wanted us to have real ground under our feet. He'd say, space is beautiful, but you can't raise a family there. I cannot rest from travel. I will drink life to the lees. All times I've enjoyed greatly have suffered greatly, both with those that loved me and alone. For always roaming with a hungry heart, much have I seen and known. Cities of men and manners, climates, councils, governments.
I didn't know you liked classical literature.
Ulysses was my dad's favorite poem. Every time he shipped out, he recorded me reading it. He had a dozen versions when he retired.
Does he still like it?
I sure hope so. I read it to his grave every time I go home. Dad passed on a few years back. He's probably still watching, though. So behave.
You mean from wherever we go after death?
Dead on, Skipper. He's with God now. That's not a problem with you, is it? That I believe in God?
You know that old saw, there's never an atheist in a foxhole? I've been in a lot of foxholes.
Yeah, I guess you have. I've met a few people who were really weirded out by my faith. Because I work in space, I can't believe in a higher power? Jeez. Hello, have you people looked out the window? How can you look at this galaxy and not believe in something? I should get back to my duties. Didn't mean to take up so much of your time.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
Not sure I buy Dr. Tassoni's story about her and her mom not talking. They're family, right?
I think she's being straight with us. Or at least, I don't think she lies very often.
Yeah, she's probably really bad at it. Too bad those ruins got destroyed. I mean, they lasted thousands of years. That's impressive.
We'll talk later, Williams.
Looking forward to it, Skipper. Hey, Skipper. Any interest in a small drink? It's a special occasion.
What's the occasion?
It's Armistice Day, when the First Contact War ended. My family always marks it. Since I'm the only Williams aboard, I thought I'd ask you.
Seems like an odd thing to celebrate. That was 26 years ago.
In our family, it's not really a celebration, more like an obligation. Don't tell me you don't know about my family. My commanders always find out. It's not in my files or something?
There's almost nothing in your files. Technical scores and a list of crap assignments.
There's a reason for the crap assignments. I'm General Williams' granddaughter, the commander of the Shanxi garrison in the war. The only human ever to surrender to an alien race.
I see. That's why you drive yourself so hard.
A Williams has to be better than the best, if only to avoid suspicion. That's what my dad told me the night before he retired. It takes a special kind of thick-headed to march into a job where your family's blacklisted. I did it anyway. I'm not gonna let our name go down with Arnold and Quisling. Granddad deserved better than that.
What happened to your grandfather after the war?
He was relieved of command as soon as Shanxi was liberated. They brought him back to Earth in irons, but there was never a trial. They quietly demoted him and stuck him behind a desk. He retired a year later and spent the rest of his life working construction in the colonies. Sometimes we hear about attempts to get him exonerated in some official way. Nothing ever comes of them.
As I recall, your grandfather held out for a long time.
The Turians wrecked the orbitals in the first wave and occupied the major cities. They sat in orbit, dropping rocks on anything that moved. Granddad dispersed the troops. But when they went into the cities for supplies, the Turians would wreck a block to eliminate one fire team. Civilians were dying, his troops were starving, and he couldn't contact Alliance High Command. So he surrendered the garrison.
I should have figured this out myself. I don't know how I can help you, though.
Look at who I am, Shepard. Do you ever hear me ask for help? It's not that bad things don't happen to me. If you stay with me long enough, maybe I'll tell you about some of them. But I deal with them myself. I don't need a shoulder to cry on, a knight to rescue me, or a man to make me happy. This is who I am. I like her. And you better like her, too. So, you still interested in me? Baggage and all?
Everyone comes with baggage, Ash. The trick is finding a matched set.
That's awful. Tell me you got that out of a fortune cookie. But hey, once we save the galaxy, maybe the Alliance will get its act together. Start acting like an actual government.
The Alliance isn't perfect, but it does well enough.
Have to disagree with you there, Skipper. Giving aliens the run of our most advanced ship? Kowtowing to the Council?
The Alliance should be able to stand on its own. We can't. Yet. Why not learn from the races who've been standing for the last 1,000 years?
How can you say that, given everything we've seen out here? They're already acting like Saren is our problem, already sicking us on the bear. The Council races will always think of themselves first. It's human nature. We can't afford to trust them, not if the survival of humanity is on the line.
Ash, you believe in God, an infallible, all-knowing creator with a plan for the universe. You think the diversity of views in the galaxy wasn't part of that?
I don't know what God intends, Shepard. I don't think humans have some divine mandate, if that's what you mean. I don't think we're superior.
Humans are aggressive. We think fast, we move fast. Wars have started because of our need for constant progress. The Council can balance that.
Well, that's... I guess I never thought of it that way. All big picture, I mean. It doesn't make what happened to Granddad any better, though.
What happened to your grandfather shouldn't have happened.
Well, at least somebody knows that. You and he would have gotten along. He was a tough old bastard. I have a feeling things will come to a head soon. But don't worry, Shepard. I'll protect you.
We'll talk later, Williams.
Looking forward to it, Skipper. There's a reason for everything that happened, Shepard, even if you don't understand it at the time. What happened on Akuz, it's not easy to lose your unit, I know. But it gave you the drive you needed on this mission. And that got you here, commanding the finest tin can in the Alliance fleet. This is exactly where the galaxy needs you to be. No pressure.
The galaxy may need me here, but I need you next to me.
God, you're awful. How do you come up with these things? Sorry, I'll be serious. I need time to think. We've been focused on the mission. When we're done, it'll be different, I swear. I hope you can wait.
There's some old saw about waiting and good things, isn't there?
You are totally shameless. You need your own line of greeting cards. I'll warn you, though. I'm a Hellcat off the battlefield, too. Sleep tight, Shepard.
We're speaking with the Krogan. The assault on Saren's base will be difficult enough as it is.
I assume that means you've come up with a plan.
Of sorts. We can convert our ship's drive system into a 20-kiloton ordnance. Crude, but effective.
Nice. Drop that nuke from orbit, and Saren can kiss his Turian ass goodbye.
Unfortunately, the facility is too well fortified for that. We'll need to place the bomb at a precise location.
Where do we take the nuke, and how do we get there?
The bomb must be taken to the far side of the facility. Your ship can drop it off, but we'll need to infiltrate the base, disable the AA guns, and pacify any ground forces first.
You want us to go in on foot? We don't have enough men.
It does sound a bit risky. Is there no other way?
No, but I think we can work around that. I'm going to divide my men into 3 teams and hit the front of the facility. While we've got their attention, you can sneak your shadow team in the back.
It's a good idea, but your people are going to get slaughtered.
We're tougher than we look, Commander. But it's true. I don't expect many of us will make it out alive. And that makes what I'm going to ask even more difficult. I need one of your men to accompany me, to help coordinate the teams.
We'll need someone who knows Alliance communication protocols.
I volunteer, Commander.
Not so fast, LT. Commander Shepard will need you to arm the nuke. I'll go with the Salarians.
With all due respect, Gunnery Chief, it's not your place to decide.
Why is it that whenever someone says, with all due respect, they really mean kiss my ass?
Williams, you'll accompany the captain. No heroics, understood?
Aye, aye, Commander.
I will have the ordnance loaded onto the Normandy and brief your crew on its detonation sequencing. Do you have any questions before we go, Commander?
I'm ready when you are, Captain.
Excellent. Then if you'll excuse me, I need to prepare my men.
Well, this is it. Don't do anything stupid while I'm gone, LT. You too, Commander.
We'll be fine. You'll see.
Yeah, I just... Good luck.
Is there something you want to say, Chief?
I don't know. It's just weird, going under someone else's command. I've got used to working with you. All of you.
Don't worry. We'll see you on the other side.
I know. It's been an honor serving with you, Commander.
It doesn't matter if we're not in the same unit. We're still a team. Watch each other's backs, keep your eyes open, and fight like I know you can. We'll all come out of this in one piece.
You bet, Commander.
In position. We're all set here.
Commander, can you read me?
The nuke is almost ready. Get to the rendezvous point, Williams.
Negative, Commander. The Geth have us pinned down on the AA tower. We've taken heavy casualties. We'll never make the rendezvous point in time.
Get them out of there, Joker. Now.
Negative. It's too hot. Can't risk it. We'll hold them off as long as we...
It's okay, Commander. I need a couple of minutes to finish arming the bomb. Go get them and meet me back here.
Up to the AA tower. Move.
Reinforcements. We better hurry.
Heads up, LT. We just spotted the troop ship headed to your location.
It's already here. There's Geth pouring out all over the bombsite.
Can you hold them off?
There's too many. I don't think we can survive until you get here. I'm activating the bomb.
Alenka, what are you doing?
I'm just making sure this bomb goes off, no matter what. It's done, Commander. Go get Williams and get the hell out of here.
Screw that. We can handle ourselves. Go back and get Alenko.
Williams, radio Joker and tell him to meet us on the AA tower.
Yes, Commander,
It's the right choice, and you know it, Ash.
I'm sorry, Caden. I had to make a choice.
I understand, Commander. I don't regret a thing.
I can't believe Caden didn't make it. How could we just leave him down there?
Alenko knew the risks going in. He gave his life to save the rest of us.
It should have been me, Commander. You know that.
It wasn't your call, Williams. I had to choose. I chose you.
I'm sorry, Commander. You saved my life. I'm grateful for that. But it should have been me. Alenko was a superior officer. I would have gladly stayed behind.
Ash, how far are you going to drive yourself? Are you trying to be a martyr? To redeem your grandfather's honor?
That's not fair.
What the public and the military did to him was unfair. But I don't want to lose you because of it.
Aye, aye, Shepard. Commander?
About Lieutenant Alenko. How are you holding up?
Can't say I'm better. Sorry for anything I said back there. I don't want any deaths on my hands, and it's my fault.
Williams, listen to me. I'm in command of this mission. I made the call, not you. He's dead because of me.
It's funny. I don't have any fear of dying for the Alliance. But when I think of someone dying for me... If you don't mind my asking... How did you deal with the losses on Akuz?
It was my job to get everyone out safe. I failed. I vowed not to let that happen again. Same here. I'll remember it, and I'll do better for him.
Yeah. I guess that's all we can do. Thanks for the advice, Skipper.
We'll talk later, Williams.
Looking forward to it, Skipper.
Good job, Shepard. Thanks to you, the Council's finally taking real action against Saren.
The Ambassador is correct. If Saren is foolish enough to attack the Citadel, as you believe, we will be ready for him.
Patrols are stationed at every mass relay linking Citadel space to the Terminus systems.
You think a blockade's going to stop him? He's on Ilos looking for the conduit right now. What are you doing about that?
Ilos is only accessible to the Mu relay, deep inside the Terminus systems, Commander. If we send a fleet in there, the only possible outcome is full-scale war.
Now is the time for discretion, Commander. Saren's greatest weapon was secrecy. Exposed, he is no longer a threat. This is over.
Sovereign's the real threat. Saren's just a servant of the Reapers.
Only you have seen the Reapers, and then only in visions. We won't invade the Terminus systems because of a dream.
One ship going into the Terminus systems won't start a war. I can be discreet.
You detonated a nuclear device on Vermeer. I wouldn't call that discreet.
Your style served you well in the Traverse, Commander. We recognize that. But Ilos requires a deft touch. We have the situation under control.
If Saren finds the conduit, we're all screwed. We have to go to Ilos.
Ambassador Udina, I get the sense Commander Shepard isn't willing to let this go.
There are serious political implications here, Shepard. Humanity's made great gains thanks to you, but now you're becoming more trouble than you're worth.
You bastard! You're selling us out!
It's just politics, Commander. You've done your job, now let me do mine. We've locked out all the Normandy's primary systems until, for the notice, you're grounded.
Nobody stabs me in the back, Udina. Nobody.
I think it's time for you and your team to leave, Commander. This no longer concerns you. The Council can handle this, with my help, of course.
How you holding up, Skipper?
This isn't over yet.
You're an optimist, Shepard. I guess we'll have to consider this part of humanity's learning experience.
We'll figure it out. We have to. Can I count on you to be there?
I know I'm not the easiest person in the world to get to know, so I'll do you a favor. Just this once. I want you to be happy. Whatever you need, I'll help. There. You made me say it. Boom goes my feminine mystique.
I've had a hell of a time figuring you out. But I think I have. I want you to be happy, too.
You better.
Sorry to interrupt, Commander. Got a message from Captain Anderson.
What did he want?
Only said to meet him in that club in the wards. Flux.
Sounds important. You'd better go.
I'm glad you came, Shepard. I heard that.
They pulled me off the mission. Just like when they forced you to give up the Normandy.
I know, I'm sorry. I wanted to warn you, but there was no way to get a message to you before you docked. I know you're pissed off right now, but you can't give up. They all think this is over, but we both know it's not. You have to go to Ilos. You have to stop Saren from using the conduit.
There's only one ship that can get me into the Terminus systems undetected, and she's grounded.
Citadel controls locked out all the Normandy's systems, but if we override the Ambassador's orders, we can get them to bring the Normandy back online. You can be in the Terminus systems before anyone even knows you're gone.
If we steal the Normandy, you're the one left holding the bag.
And if Saren finds the conduit, life as we know it is over. The Reapers will destroy us. Humans, Asari, everybody. You're the only one who can stop him, Shepard. So I'll do whatever it takes to get you on the Normandy and off this station.
Stealing the Normandy is mutiny. What if the crew won't help me?
The Normandy's your ship now, Commander. Her crew will follow you to the ends of the galaxy. We both know that.
I won't forget this, Captain. I promise.
I can unlock the Normandy from one of the consoles in the Citadel Control Center. You'll have a few minutes before anyone realizes what happened.
That's a restricted area, patrolled by armed guards. How are you going to get in?
Leave that to me. Just make sure you're in the Normandy when the systems come back online.
You're gonna get yourself killed. There has to be another way.
Ambassador Udina issued the lockdown order. If I can hack into the computer in his office, maybe I can override it.
He's not gonna let you waltz into his office and use his computer.
Hopefully he won't be there. If he is, I'll just have to think of something.
Udina won't let this slide, Captain. You'll be charged with treason, a capital offense.
We don't have a lot of options. I break into the ambassador's computer, or I take my chances with the patrols in Citadel Control.
You'll have a better chance if you go after the ambassador's computer.
I was hoping you'd say that. The ambassador has made this personal. You ready to get the hell off this station, Commander?
Let's do it.
I'll take care of the lockdown. You get down to the Normandy and tell Joker to stand by.
Some humans are angry at the Quarians after the attack on Eden Prime. After all, you created the Geth.
The Geth killed billions and forced us from our homeworld. Most Quarians believe we have paid properly for our mistake.
Hopefully, having you with us fighting Saren will change people's minds.
Anderson, what are you doing here?
I didn't send...
Get us out of here, Joker. Now!
Skipper?
Don't you think we're a little past titles?
We had to do this, Shepard. You know that. There was no other way. And you'll always be the skipper to me. Oh, Captain, my Captain.
First Alfred Tennyson, now Walt Whitman. You're full of surprises.
Dad loved all those sappy poets. Mom was more into Plath. I'm not a word person, Shepard. Other people say what I mean better than I do. We're mutineers, sailing a stolen warship into the most hostile system in the galaxy. I couldn't blame the Council for calling us reckless or aggressive.
Just a few months ago, you would have.
I've had some things to think about since coming aboard. Death closes all. But something ere the end, some work of noble note, may yet be done. Not unbecoming men that strove with gods. We'll get home again, Shepard. I believe you'll lead us through. Oh, Captain, my Captain.
Is my rank all you see when you look at me?
No. I see a strong, passionate man. With a great ass. There are regs against this, you know. You ready to deal with the consequences? I've spent my whole life fighting to get what I want. To get it done, I had to bury a lot of things. During that whole time, not even once did I feel like I was worth what I was fighting for. You make me feel good enough.
Bunk here tonight, Ash. With me.
Bold word, Shepard. I like bold.
This isn't a contest, Ash.
This isn't an act, Shepard. But you'll learn.
Thank you.
That's a whole new spin for on the floor and give me 20, huh?
Would you roll your eyes if I said this is the first time in months I felt that all's right in the galaxy?
Yes?
Bridge to Commander Shepard. We're 5 minutes out from the Mew Relay.
Well, duty calls. Get up to the bridge, Skipper. I've got other weapons to check out. Hey, Shepard. Whatever happens down there, I just wanted to say... Wait. You know what? I'm not telling you. You want to hear this? You'll just have to come back to me. This is bigger than humanity! Sovereign's a threat to every organic species in the galaxy!
The Council must be sacrificed for the greater good. Do not waste your reinforcements. Hold them back until the Citadel arms open up. Save the human fleet to attack Sovereign.
What's the order, Commander? Come in now to save the Ascension, or we will back.
Opening the relays now, Joker. We need to save the Ascension, no matter what the cost.
The noble choice. I just hope it does not also turn out to be the wrong one.
Alliance ships, move in. Save the Destiny Ascension.
Commander, we're picking up reinforcements. It's the Alliance. Thank the goddess.
Safe now. Where's the commander?
Everybody in! Go! Go! Go!
Ashley Williams?
She's still with the Alliance. Promoted, I believe. Her file is surprisingly well classified.
What happened to Gunnery Chief Williams after the Normandy was destroyed?
Operations Chief Williams is still with the Alliance, but she's working on a special mission. It's classified. I can't say any more. Not while you're working with Cerberus, I'm sorry.
Shepard, I think we have them. Horizon, one of our colonies in the Terminus systems, just went silent. If it isn't under attack, it soon will be. Has Morden delivered the countermeasure for the Seeker Swarms?
Not yet.
Let's hope he works well under pressure. There's something else you should know. One of your former crew, Ashley Williams, she's stationed on Horizon.
Last I knew, Ash was Alliance. Why is she out in the Terminus systems?
Officially, it's an outreach program to improve Alliance relation with the colonies. But they're up to something. And if they sent Chief Williams, it must be big. Perhaps you should take it up with her.
The Collectors just happened to pick a colony with one of my former crew? I don't buy it.
It shouldn't be a surprise the Collectors are interested in you, especially if they're working for the Reapers. They might be going after her to get to you.
We should send a message to the Citadel. The Alliance can give us reinforcements.
Not until you investigate. I don't want the Alliance getting in our way. Once you have the situation under control, I'll send the message personally.
Send the coordinates. We'll head straight there.
This is the most warning we've ever had, Shepard. Good luck.
Lilith, we've got a problem.
Still can't calibrate the targeting matrix?
Those defense towers are useless if we don't figure it out.
Sorry, Chief. Getting our comm systems back online takes priority.
Yeah. Okay. Surprised people haven't tried to blame that one on me, too.
People out here don't trust the Alliance. It's nothing personal. What is that?
Get everyone to the safe house. I'll cover you! Run!
Company. Get out here. Now.
You're human. What are you doing out here? You'll lead them right here.
I cleared a path. You're lucky you're not in the hold of a collector ship right now.
Those things are collectors? You mean, they're real? I thought they were just made up, you know, propaganda, to keep us in Alliance space. No, they got Lilith. I saw her go down. Sten, too. They got damn near everybody.
What's your name? What do you do here?
Name's Delanne. Mechanic. I came down to check on the main grid after we lost our comm signals. And I heard screaming. I looked outside and there were swarms of bugs. Everyone they touched just froze. I sealed the doors. Damn it, it's the Alliance's fault. They stationed that Chief Williams here and built those defense towers. It made us a target.
Tell me more about this Alliance rep.
Chief Williams? Heard she was some kind of hero or something. Didn't mean nothing to me, though. Would rather she just stayed back in Council space.
Any idea what she was doing on Horizon?
Supposed to be helping us get the defense towers up and running. I got the feeling she was here for something else. Spying on us, maybe.
They have most of the humans on board. They got with...
No! Don't let him get away!
There's nothing we can do. They're gone.
Half the colony's in there. They took Egan and Sam and Lilith. Do something!
I didn't want it to end this way. I did what I could.
It was a good fight, Shepard.
Shepard? Wait. I know that name. Sure, I remember you. You're some type of big Alliance hero.
Commander Shepard, captain of the Normandy, the first human Spectre, savior of the Citadel. You're in the presence of a god, Delanne. Back from the dead.
All the good people we lost and you get left behind. Figures. Screw this. I'm done with you Alliance types.
I thought you were dead, Shepard. We all did.
It's been too long, Ash. How have you been?
That's it? You show up after 2 years and act like nothing's happened? We had something, Shepard. Something real. I loved you. I thought you were dead. I almost... How could you put me through that? Why didn't you try to contact me? Why didn't you let me know you were alive?
Not my choice. I spent the last 2 years in some kind of coma while Cerberus rebuilt me.
You're with Cerberus now? I can't believe the reports were right.
Reports? So much for security.
Alliance intel said Cerberus could be behind our missing colonies. We got a tip that this one could be the next to get hit. I went to Anderson, but he wouldn't talk. But there were rumors that you weren't dead. Worse, that you were working for the enemy.
Our colonies are disappearing. The Alliance turned its back on them. Cerberus is the only group willing to do something about it.
Bullshit. I know what Cerberus is like. They talk about putting humans first, but at what cost? I wanted to believe that you were alive. I just never expected anything like this. How could you just turn your back on all of us? You betrayed the Alliance. Anderson, you betrayed me.
Ash, you know me. You know I'd only do this for the right reason. You saw it yourself. The Collectors are targeting human colonies, and they're working with the Reapers.
I'd like to believe you, Shepard, but I don't trust Cerberus. And it worries me that you do. What did they do to you? What if they're behind it? What if they're the ones working with the Collectors?
Typical Alliance attitude. You're so focused on Cerberus that you're blind to the real threat.
You're letting how you feel about their history get in the way of facts.
Or maybe you feel like you owe Cerberus because they saved you. Maybe it's you. Doesn't matter. I still know where my loyalties lie. I'm an Alliance soldier. It's in my blood. I'm reporting back to the Citadel. I'll let them decide if they believe your story.
I could use someone like you and my crew, Ash. It'll be just like old times.
No, it won't. I'm no fan of aliens, but Cerberus has a history of being extremist. I'll never work for a group like that. Goodbye, Shepard. Just try to be careful.
Joker, send the shuttle to pick us up. I've had enough of this colony.
There's no looking back. The same goes for you. Can I assume you've put your past relationships behind you?
None of your damn business.
If it affects the mission, better you should leave it behind.
Hey, Commander. It's, pretty crazy the people you can run into out here, huh? I mean, it was probably a setup or something, but it was still good to see Ash, Operations Chief Williams, wasn't it?
We talked, but things have changed. We let it go.
Oh, good, because I was not looking forward to your mood if that went bad. There's a reason I don't date crew, Commander.
I saw the reports on Horizon, Commander. What you did was amazing. The report mentioned that Ashley Williams was there. How did that go?
We've been through a lot. I wish we could have had more time together.
Do you have strong feelings for her?
Ashley's an incredible woman. I didn't like saying goodbye.
I'm sorry. Parting ways with someone so close is never easy.
I appreciate that, but I'll be okay.
Shepard.
Ashley.
Lieutenant Commander, how'd it go in there?
I can never tell with them. I'm just waiting for orders now.
Lieutenant Commander?
You hadn't heard?
No, I hadn't.
Sorry, Shepard. It's been... well...
That's okay. Just glad I bumped into you, Ash.
Me too.
Admiral.
Come on.
You know the commander?
I used to.
Let's go.
Weren't they?
Sure looked like it.
What's Cerberus doing here on Mars?
Good question.
You don't know?
I'm not with them anymore, Ash, if that's what you're asking.
It wasn't, but you have to admit, it's a bit convenient.
answer, Shepard.
Ash.
Look, don't ash me. Do you know anything about this? What is Cerberus doing here?
What makes you think I know what they're up to?
You worked for them. How am I supposed to believe you've cut all ties?
We joined forces to take down the Collectors. That's it.
They rebuilt you from scratch. They gave you a ship, resources.
Let me be clear. I've had no contact with Cerberus since I destroyed the Collector base. And I have no idea why they're here now or what they want. Commander Shepard's been under constant surveillance since coming back to Earth. No way they've communicated since.
Sorry, Shepard. I just...
You of all people should know what I'm about, Ash. Please, trust me.
I do. It's just that... Shepard, I found something.
What have you got?
He's got a transmitter in his helmet. If I can... Oh! Oh, God. He looks like a husk.
Yeah, not quite. But they've definitely done something to him.
Engineered? By Cerberus? They claim to stand for humanity, and they do this to their own people. That could have been you, Shepard. For all I knew, that's what Cerberus had done to you.
How can you compare me to that thing?
I don't know what you are. Not since they got their hands on you. Is it really you in there? Do you even know? I mean, could they be controlling you?
Ash.
I'm just talking out loud. I don't need you to answer. I doubt there's anything you could say to convince me. I guess I just need some time to get to know you again. To find the guy I used to love.
I'm the same person I always was, Ash. And I want you with me. Wherever this takes us.
That's what I needed to hear.
Good.
We need the data.
Shepard, we got Reaper signatures in orbit.
Ash. Come on, Ash. I'm getting you out of here.
Ashley needs medical attention. We have to leave the Sol system.
I know.
The Citadel is our best chance. We can find help there.
Get us to the Citadel, Joker.
Roger that.
Hold on, Ash. Ashley's been hurt. We're taking her to the Citadel.
Sorry to hear that, Shepard. But we both know this is just the beginning.
Barely got a pulse here.
Move him out.
Where are you taking her?
Where to Memorial. Best care in the Citadel.
We're not going with?
We need to see the Council.
Right.
I assume you're here about Lieutenant Commander Williams?
How's Ashley doing?
The head trauma was severe, but we reduced the swelling quickly. These types of injury can go either way. She hasn't regained consciousness yet, but her vitals are strong, so I'm optimistic. You can go see her if you like. She's just down the hall.
Ash. Hey. It's Shepard. I should have known you'd pull through. You're stubborn. Always were. It scared me pretty bad back there on Mars. I just wanted to check in on you. See how you're doing. Despite all this, it's good seeing you again, Ash. Get some rest, okay? I'll come by when you're feeling better. We'll talk. You need anything, Doc, let me know. Okay, Ash. You take care. I'll see you soon. People around me have a tendency to get hurt. Or worse. Ash is just the latest in a long line.
She's a soldier like you. And she's a fighter. If anyone can get better on Will alone, it's her.
I hope you're right.
Commander Shepard, when I heard Earth was under attack, I tried to call. I never got through.
Thane, good to see you staying in shape.
My disease kills slowly. With enough care and a healthy lifestyle, it can be delayed for a few years. Of course, my allotted time has come and gone. Now I exercise because it pleases me. What are you doing here?
Visiting a friend who got hurt protecting me. Ashley.
The dark-haired human woman in intensive care. She will be starting physical therapy with my class soon.
That's her.
If she means something to you, then I will help how I can. As long as she is here, consider her under my protection.
I appreciate it, Thane.
I am near the end of my life. It is a good time to be generous.
I'd like an answer, Lieutenant Commander. The galaxy has need of exceptional soldiers like you, now more than ever.
I still need time. You'll have my answer soon, I promise.
I look forward to it. Shepard?
Odina? I got your email. Made your decision yet?
On becoming a Spectre? Not yet. It's an honor and all. But I don't know. I need to think about it some more.
It's a big decision. Smart to give it some thought. Here, I picked this up for you. Figured you had some downtime.
Thanks. That's sweet. I've been climbing the walls.
How are you doing?
Good, considering. The nurse said you checked in on me earlier. Still out cold, I guess.
We didn't have time to talk. I thought maybe if you were up for it.
Yeah, I wasn't sure you wanted to. You were pretty clear on Mars about where things stood.
What do you mean?
You're not a part of Cerberus anymore. Case closed. Full stop.
It's the truth.
Okay. You cut all ties. I accept that. But where do we stand, Shepard? Did we cut all ties?
Ash. It's always been you. When we didn't see eye to eye, I gave you as much time as I could. That's done now. I'm not doing this without you. I need you.
Shepard... Damn it, you sure know how to sweep a girl off her feet.
You're already lying down.
Romantic moment destroyed.
Sorry.
Thanks. I needed something good. It's been rough.
Okay, get some rest. You need anything at all, let me know.
Shepard, wait. There's one more thing. I wasn't sure if I should mention it.
What is it?
I have family back on Earth. I haven't heard from them. It's making me crazy. But I know you're busy, Shepard. We can talk later.
I've got time to talk. Who's back on Earth?
Mom plus my three sisters. The youngest, Sarah, was away on her honeymoon. Married a military man, Thomas. He got called back in and she was stuck alone. She called me. It's been pretty tough.
I imagine.
I was always there to protect them growing up. Even when I was off on tour, they knew they could talk to me. I told her to come to the Citadel. We could wait for news together.
I didn't hear from you while I was a guest of the Alliance.
I couldn't face you, even when Anderson requested my presence. It was difficult.
It's okay. We're past that. Fresh start.
It's gonna take time.
Copy that. But not too long. The bad guys aren't taking coffee breaks.
Okay. What is this? Healing through guilt?
Seems to be working. We can't afford to be at each other's throats. If we plan on getting through this, we need to trust each other.
I was trying to keep the family stuff to myself, to be professional. I don't know how you managed to keep it all together.
I have my moments, believe me.
You know, I'm glad to hear it.
Have you heard anything about Earth?
We have reports coming all the time on what's going on. Half are wild speculation, and half are probably too optimistic to be true.
We have to believe that we can do something.
When I thought you were dead, I lost hope, I'm telling you. But when you came back, I was ready to believe anything. I mean, maybe this problem can't be solved by some grunt shooting the boogeyman in the face, but if you think it might help, I'm game.
That sounds more like the Ash I know. So, what's all this Lieutenant Commander business?
Seems like the old Williams curse is losing its grip. Was sure I'd top out at Gunnery Chief.
You've worked hard. You deserve it.
I thought so too. Until Eden Prime. Losing 212 was... Well, you know.
It was the Reapers, Ash. You did the best you could, and survived to help us.
Just... Losing everyone under my command, it's tough to face. I'll never forget any of them.
Right now, we need you back on your feet.
I'll be back. And first order of business is to shove their metal tentacles right up there. I'll fight with honor and courage, sir.
Roger that, Elsie. I should get back to it. Take care of yourself.
You too, Shepard.
Good to see you up and around.
Yeah.
Everything all right?
I guess. Oh, I took Udina's offer.
Spectre status. Congratulations.
Seems small compared to what's going on.
You ready for the responsibilities of a Spectre?
Doesn't feel real yet. Maybe it'll sink in. I don't know what duties I'll have. Everything's a mess right now. What do you think of all this?
You're a fine soldier with an impressive record. You deserve this.
Thanks. That means a lot coming from you. He said we'll have the official ceremony soon.
once I'm out of here.
And after? Any plans to come back to the Normandy?
If I have anything to say about it, yes.
I'm glad. You feeling better?
I'm fine. Other than the pile of paperwork the doc's gonna throw at me. Sorry I'm so distracted, Shepard. It's just...
What's going on?
I heard from my mom. They got out in time. They're okay.
Good. That's good news.
It is.
Did your sister make it to the Citadel?
She did. But... her husband was killed in action.
I'm sorry, Ash.
Thanks. Yeah. Sarah wasn't much for the military life. We were all surprised when they got married.
I wonder how many families are getting torn apart by the Reapers.
I don't want to think about it. Seems hopeless sometimes.
Don't blame yourself for this, Ashley.
I know. But I'm her big sis, you know? In the fell clutch of circumstance, I have not winced or cried aloud. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is bloody, but unbowed.
What's that from?
Invictus, by Henley. One of my dad's sappy poets.
It's about not giving up.
Right. My sister wants to do a thing at the memorial. Nothing fancy. Just some words about the family. It'll be tough.
Keep me posted, all right?
Will do. And thanks, Shepard.
What was that?
Gunman, get down! Go! Damn it! Cerberus hit the shuttle! Everybody back to the elevator! Shepard?
Shepard's blocking our escape. He's with Cerberus.
Everybody, hang on. Shepard, what's happening here?
You know me better than this, Ash.
I knew the old Shepard before Cerberus. Right now, I'm not sure who I'm dealing with.
We don't have time to negotiate. You've been fooled, all of you. Budina's behind this attack. The Salarian Counselor confirmed it.
Please, you have no proof. You never do.
There are Cerberus soldiers in the elevator shaft behind us. If you open that door, they'll kill you all.
We've mistrusted Shepard before, and it did not help us.
We don't have time to debate this. We're dead if we stay out here. I'm overriding the lock.
I'm gonna regret this.
No. You're not.
All right, Skipper.
Udina, step back from the console.
To hell with this.
Gun!
Get the council back and cover that door.
The door!
Bailey?
Made it as fast as we could, Shepard. Looks like you took care of things.
Something's not right. You said Cerberus was targeting us. Where did their soldiers go?
Cerberus was right here, but they beat feet into the Keeper tunnels when they figured out we were coming. Sorry, Counselor, I'll say it plain. Shepard just saved the lot of you.
And you have saved my life twice now, Shepard. I owe you both a personal debt, and one on behalf of Palavan.
You don't owe me anything, Counselor. Times like this, we all stand together.
Commander, do you have any idea why the elusive man would do this?
No, I don't. But I plan to find out.
All right, people. Principals are evacuated. We got a tunnel and a million more places to secure. Move it!
Shepard. I don't know what to say. I'm trying to go over everything in my head.
make sense of it.
Your bandages were still fresh. How did you end up working with Adina?
You saw me in the hospital. I was going crazy. Felt like I was letting everyone down. When Adina offered to make me a Spectre, I thought it was a chance to do some good.
I couldn't just sit back and watch either.
Yeah. But it sure turned into a mess.
I never wanted to put you in that situation. We're on the same side.
I can't believe it came to that. We were so close to...
Ash, it's okay. We figured it out. We stopped Adina and got to walk away. That's the important part.
I can't believe he was responsible for all of it. Was he indoctrinated?
It's hard to say.
How do we fight something that can worm its way into your head?
I don't know. But we don't have a choice.
I wanted to talk to you about that. Hackett asked me to join his team. It's a great offer, but... I'd prefer to ride this thing out aboard the Normandy.
Permission granted. Couldn't do this without you.
I'll grab my gear.
And Ash?
Yeah?
It's good to have you back.
Yes, sir.
Shepard. Hell of a day. Udina loses his mind, the Citadel almost falls, and you almost had to put down a friend.
Got a little tense there.
If it had come down to it, could you have pulled the trigger?
I don't see how. We start killing our friends, and war turns into murder.
But it doesn't always give us the easy way out, does it? At least Ash didn't have to join Caden.
Let's hope he's looking out for us. This was his fight, too.
Letters my youngest sister wrote when she was in high school. She was... having a hard time. Teen drama and all that. Just needed her big sis. I guess with everything that happened down there, I just wanted to read them again. Shepard, thanks for coming.
I wanted to be here for you, Ash.
It's tough to see her go through this, There I go again.
I hope Sarah can find some peace here.
I'm glad I can be here for her. She wanted me to say something about her family.
You'll get through this. You need to be strong for Sarah now.
You're right. I'm so proud of her. She's no career soldier, but there she is, coping with all this. Reminds me of Dad. Whatever was going on, he put a smile on his face for us.
Your family made you what you are.
He did his best with four daughters and a strong wife. He always said, live fire exercises was good prep for facing his girly horde.
Your sister's waiting. You'll be fine.
Right. Here we go. Okay. Remember the trip to the beach the summer before I left for basic training? So the Geth had a few new tricks up their metal sleeves. Maybe I should be more open-minded. But I'd rather scope down some tin can than a person. I'm right. Right? Fine. I'll shut up.
Ash?
Oh.
What have we here?
Oh, sir. I'm off duty. Your voice? Sir, not so loud. Please, thank you.
Why are you curled up on the floor?
Am I? Oh, my head. So heavy. Can't move.
Ah. Enjoy your evening?
I'll be back to work in 30. Maybe 40. I swear. Just give me 45 minutes. Shh.
How did you end up in this sorry state?
Just wanted to let off some steam. Vega said he had just the thing to take my mind off stuff.
And did that thing come in a bottle?
Yes.
This empty bottle?
It's empty. Oh boy.
You know, I think it might be time to test the fire alarm.
I'll pay you a million credits not to do that, sir.
2 million, and we have a deal.
You're a damn space pirate.
I could order Joker to sing to you over the comm.
I hate you.
I hate you...
sir.
As you were, Williams.
Cold floor.
This is a nice spot, Ash.
Yeah. All the shuttle zipping around remind me of when my dad would get ready to ship out. My mom would bundle us all up, buy us ice cream, and cart us out to the shipyard to watch his transport depart. I still have to resist waving every time a big Alliance ship flies by.
You should bring Sarah up here.
I will, when she's ready. She'll like the quiet. She wasn't the loud tomboy crashing around like I was.
Sounds like you were a handful.
Maybe. My dad got me. Shame you never met him. He would have liked you.
You think so?
Career military man? Yeah. Yeah, he would have invited you over, cooked you something on the grill, and talked your ear off.
Ever think about what life would have been like outside the Alliance?
Oh, sure. Tried to rebel against the whole military family thing when I was growing up. When my dad and I got into it, I'd threaten to run away with the next guy that came along.
Really?
He'd laugh and say, "Good, I'll pack your damn bags myself." That tended to deflate me pretty quick. He knew I'd never stray far from the family. They're everything to me.
That sounds great, Ash. But right now, I can't focus on anything but you.
Well now, those big, powerful Citadel arms giving you ideas, Commander?
Maybe.
Then maybe I have something to ask you.
What?
Well, we had something before. A long time ago. Something important. You've seen me at my worst. Totally embarrassing. You were there for me when my baby sister was suffering. I've held a gun in you, Shepard. I'm just saying, we've been through a lot. I have to know. Are we going somewhere?
I want more, Ash. I can't see myself with anyone else.
That's good. I'd hate to have to punch out whichever table-dancing tart is throwing herself at you this time.
Such a romantic.
You love it. Nugget.
Remind me.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry, Shepard. You all right?
I'm fine.
Liara?
I don't know.
Okay, I'll talk to her.
Thanks. This isn't something she should deal with by herself.
Same goes for you.
Sure.
I can't get that place out of my head. The whole thing was so calculated. Using hope to lure people to their deaths, or worse. I can't understand it. And you know, I'm glad I can't. It makes me feel human. You, having a bad day, Shepard?
You could say that.
Landing pad is just over there, but it's behind a locked gate.
Let's look for a control panel.
Nice outfit. Control panel, right. Heard you fell through a fish tank.
We'll talk about it later.
It's kind of a shame. Great sushi there.
We'll talk about it later. Stand back.
Hang on. Hey,
can you open the gate? Thanks.
Please leave.
Well, I could have done that.
Someone want to tell me what's going on here?
Yeah, who were those guys? They were heavily armed and using C-Sec shuttles.
I don't know. I've never seen them before.
I can't believe you survived all that. They had guns and grenades and those drone things.
It's all right. I'm calling Commander Bailey, see what's going on with C-Sec.
Okay, that sounds... Wait! Wouldn't that just make whoever you contact a target too?
She's right, Shepard. Until we know more, it's a big risk.
Okay. For now, we run this ourselves.
Right. Ourselves. On our own. Outside the law. Okay. Yeah.
Brooks, it's okay. I know this is a lot to deal with.
I got shot. I got medigel, but still, I took a desk job explicitly to not get shot. And you killed 100 guys with a pistol!
Well, yes, that did happen.
I mean, who does that? Well, you, I guess. But besides you, they said the medigel might make me jumpy. Do I seem jumpy?
How did you get mixed up in this?
I monitored data for Alliance Intel to prevent fraud and hacking of officer IDs. Like, someone using an admiral's pass to get into a nightclub on the Citadel when that admiral is fighting on T'Chanka. I wrote a tracking program. It's really neat. I named it Mr. Biscuits, after my cat.
Brooks.
Right, sorry. Anyway, my program detected a breach in your classified files. Soon, everything we had on you was compromised. Personnel files, mission reports, everything.
Since when does hacking personnel records involve heavy weapon fire?
Think of what criminals could do if they had Shepard's military access codes. Or Spectre codes, even.
Explains why they need you dead, Shepard. Nothing to stop them till the damage is done.
Okay. Let's figure out who they are and shut them down. Ideas?
Maybe. That pistol you picked up.
For such a tiny thing, it packs a punch. Never seen anything like it before.
Let me see it. I might be able to help. Glyph.
I'll begin collating relevant intel for review, Dr. Tassoni.
Liara?
Shepard, I'm relieved to see you're in one piece. A shame about the sushi place, though. It was a favorite.
I hear that.
All right, Liara's on point. What about the rest of the crew?
Yeah, what about those slackers?
Joker, you've been busy.
I found some folks who actually like being shot at.
Permission to come aboard, Shepard?
Glad Liara's on this. If anybody can sift through a mountain of boring stuff to find that one critical clue, it's her.
Looking good, Commander. Lean and mean.
Business now. Pleasure later.
Sir? Yes, sir.
How are you so calm? Well, you did run under a Reaper while it fought a Thresha Maw, so this is no big deal for you.
Relax, Brooks.
Right. Okay. On it.
Hell of a party. Too bad the host died.
It wasn't a total loss. Brooks, work with Edie to see if there's anything useful on those drives.
Here's hoping. I'll let you know what we find, Commander.
Fancy party? Check. Super sexy outfit? Check. Fights crime? Check. Well, almost. We got close.
Damn close.
You.
Then why are you trying to kill us?
Because I don't have his memories. I'd never fool my supposed friends. The ones who abandoned their duty to join the cult of Shepard. Like you, Lieutenant Commander Williams. I would have picked the other one on Vermeier. Caden something?
You're just a pale imitation of the real thing.
That can't be good.
Brooks, the vault sealed us in.
Is there an override?
Not seeing one.
Cortez? Brooks? Do you read me? Is anyone on this frequency?
The short answer is no. They're not. The longer answer involves your friends trapped in Iridium vaults and forgotten for, well, forever. Others know about this. About you. The Alliance will stop you. What do you think, Staff Analyst Brooks? Will the Alliance stop us?
I wouldn't know. I don't actually work for them.
What was the point of it all?
All we really wanted was your Spectre code.
I got Shepard.
Spectre access accepted.
But then you survived the hit and insisted on bringing your damned Asari into it. So I had to tie up loose ends.
The arms dealer.
Elijah, it's me. We need to talk.
What the hell's going on? I swear, if those guns get tracked back to me...
They won't. But then your sex bot just had to go and recover the data. So here we are, forced to contain the situation.
Who the hell are you?
And do you really think I won't track you down?
My name doesn't matter. I never keep the same one for more than a few days. And if the elusive man hasn't found me yet, you never will.
You're Cerberus?
Was. Mr. Elusive and I didn't see eye to eye. He's indoctrinated, whereas I prefer the whispers in my head to be my own.
Why not come to me? We could have worked together.
In a way, we did. I'm the one who put together all those dossiers on your suicide mission.
The Collector base?
There was the Salarian Doctor, the Asari Justicar, the Drell. They were all mistakes. We were a pro-human group who started looking to aliens for help. So I bided my time. And when I found another you who agreed, I woke him up.
The minute, the second I get out of here, I'm gonna take your head and mount it in the Normandy CIC. Then I'm gonna mount his head next to yours. Then I'm gonna take both of your heads and space them out the airlock.
Sign me up for that.
That sounds very dramatic. And if someone like, say, Commander Shepard made the threat, I'd be worried. But you're not Shepard. Not anymore.
You had Miranda. I have her. Mine has more bite.
It was fun while it lasted.
What are you doing? Setting things right. Remember this?
You were the first human Spectre, Commander. This is a great accomplishment for you and your entire species.
Except somewhere along the way, you forgot about your entire species. You've saved more alien lives than you have human. I don't care what species they are. Every life counts. But maybe a clone wouldn't understand that. You know the one thing they can't duplicate? Our handprint. Life gives it its shape, not DNA. Which is a problem. Computer, update Council records. Subject, Shepard. Human Spectre.
Accessing record. Please input new data. Biometric identifier updated. Good day, Commander Shepard.
Now, if you'll excuse me, the Normandy needs its captain. So, I should go.
Farewell, Commander. I guess this is where legends go to die.
Refresh my memory. Didn't we used to win these things back in the old days?
He said, I should go. Do I sound like that?
As long as I've known you, yeah.
Maybe we should be worrying about the impregnable vault we've been sealed inside forever.
How come nobody told me this before? I'm open to feedback here.
Well, I thought all humans said it, like some weird Earth custom or something.
Yeah, probably not a lot of air in here either. An hour tops.
Maybe it's, I should go. I should go. I should go.
Shepard, we're in kind of a situation here.
Oh, Glyph, you still out there?
Yes, Commander.
Unlock this damn thing and go find the others. No one steals my ship. Not even me.
Shepard's got a clone. Makes sense when you think about it.
I can explain more later. For now, it's sealed.
They're about to take off.
Is there anyone still aboard who can help us?
No. I was only there because I helped with the Normandy retrofits back on Earth. Everyone else is on shore leave.
Okay. You know this ship inside and out. Can you get me inside?
There's an emergency exit hatch for evacuations. It should be right here.
Manual lock. and it's only meant to be open from the other side. Any ideas?
We can't hack it. We need a very precise mass effect field to get it from out here.
If you told me this morning that a toothbrush was gonna save the Normandy, I'd have been very skeptical. Pretty sure we broke Trainer's toothbrush getting the hatch open. Remind me to reimburse her for that.
It's my highest priority, Commander.
You messed with my hamster, guys. Now it's personal. Guys? Were you gonna say something, or... No, I get it. Hard to even find the words.
Remember all those years ago on the Citadel? When I asked who'd win in a fight between you and Shepard? Remember how you thought it was a pointless question? Look at us now.
Yeah, you were right.
Look on the bright side. In a few minutes, you'll have your answer.
Man, I love shore leave.
I'm looking for a Lieutenant Williams. Thanks.
There you are. Ready to see who's the real Spectre and who's the pretender?
Whatever you say, Williams. Line them up.
That's what I like to hear. Rules are simple. I take a shot, you take a shot. Hesitate, game over.
This shouldn't take too long.
Uh-huh. Glamorous and beautiful superstar Spectre agent first. Sorry as pretender next.
I'll try and go easy on you so you don't break a nail, Princess.
You did not just say that.
I sure did.
Oh, I'm gonna enjoy this.
Know any poems about crying like a little girl?
Cheap shot. You know, I expected better from you.
I'm saving my best moves for later.
Best moves. At least if you're drunk, you have an excuse for how you dance. Boom!
Keep it coming, Lieutenant. I can do this all night.
You may have to.
You know, Williams, I can think of a few other ways to test your endurance.
Shepard, what kind of girl do you think I am?
Hey, my friend doesn't like alliance types.
Buddy, we're right in the middle of something.
I don't like alliance types either.
Rain check?
Yeah. Everybody in the same place at the same time. Unbelievable.
Hey, everyone. Come over here for a minute. Let's get a photo to remember this. Arrange yourselves on the sofa.
An excellent suggestion, Shepard.
Great idea. I want a copy.
Make way! Make way!
Thanks for coming, everyone. Here's to us. Ready, Glyph?
Of course. If you could all please direct your attention this way.
Okay. Everyone say Normandy.
Normandy!
Hey, you.
Hey, yourself, pretty lady. Good morning.
I hope you don't have too many new bruises.
Just enough to get my attention. Let's see if anyone else is up.
Time to get back out there, huh?
At least we threw one hell of a party. Probably the last one.
No. No, you'll find a way to beat the odds. And when you do, Hero Man, I'll be waiting. I wouldn't have missed any of it for the world. Good ride.
The best.
Everything's ready, Shepard.
What about you? Are you ready?
Let's get it done and go home.
We're not getting off that easy, Ash.
No. We looking at a rough ride?
Ash, I get what you're trying to do.
Hey, no brushing me off. Talk to me. What's going on?
I'm not brushing you off. I'm just thinking about everyone we've lost fighting this war.
I understand. And do I ever. You know, I was lost without you, Shepard. When I thought you were dead, it broke my heart. And then you found your way back. It was a miracle. Screw the science. It was a damn miracle, Shepard.
I couldn't do this without you, Ashley. When I first met you back on Eden Prime, I saw a woman who never gave up. You lost your company, expected no help, and there you were, fighting an invasion single-handed.
You don't need to say anything, Shepard.
No, I do. I love you.
I doubted you once, Shepard, and I lost you. That's not happening again. Just shut up and kiss me. Hey. You okay?
Having trouble sleeping, I guess.
I'm surprised you slept at all with everything going on.
Yeah, you're right. Just jitters, I guess.
Just jitters, he says. You amaze me.
What?
Nothing. I love you.
You being here with me? It means everything.
Shepard.
Shh. I love you.
It can't be done. It's not a matter of resources.
It's always a matter of resources. We're not losing Shepard.
Sir, Shepard is clinically brain dead. After that much trauma, that long with no oxygen, we cannot overcome nature.
Operative Lawson disagrees. She is now in charge of Project Lazarus.
I didn't realize it was that bad.
I thought you were just unconscious. That sounds like more.
Looks like.
How did it feel? Do you remember anything from while you were under?
I'm still me. I doubt I'd have been able to turn against Cerberus otherwise. I don't remember anything. Maybe they really just fixed me, or maybe I'm just a high-tech VI that thinks it's Commander Shepard. But I don't know, I...
Screw those Cerberus freaks. Whatever anyone says, you're you.
Tissue regeneration is proceeding. The helmet kept the brain intact, for whatever good that will do.
Lawson will find a way.
Sir, you realize that Shepard is a veteran of Akuz. A Cerberus operation wiped out his entire squad.
Shepard's a soldier. He knows the Reapers are the real threat. He'll work with us.
And you did.
Every instinct I had told me not to trust Cerberus. But I needed their help. So I played along.
You did what you had to. Now let's go put it right.
Project Lazarus is reporting neurological activity. They're requesting more funding.
Granted. Get me our potential recruits file. Shepard will be up soon. We need a crew.
Our existing forces should be more than sufficient.
No. We need sympathetic faces. I need Shepard invested. Tap Kelly Chambers and recruit Donnelly. I imagine Miss Daniels will follow. We'll want some old friends as well. Contact Dr. Chakwaz and send me the psych profile on Shepard's pilot, along with a bottle of 47 Thessia Red.
That son of a bitch set you up. Hey.
How are you holding up?
Restless. Everything depends on this. Think we have a chance?
There's always hope. That's how we got this far.
And you made it happen, Shepard. You're the reason we're here.
I've had people like you picking me up and dusting me off when I stumbled. Lost count of all the times you've saved me.
Almost as many times as you saved me, hero man. It always comes down to this. Feels like 1,000 years since we met on Eden Prime. So much has happened. It's hard to figure out how we got here.
You're a survivor, Ash. Always were.
I hope you're right.
Boldly they rode, and well. Into the jaws of death. Into the mouth of hell.
I don't want you to go. I love you, Shepard.
I love you too. You ready?
I'm ready.
Then let's get it done and go home.
Aye, aye, Captain.
From here on in, it's a straight shot to the beach.
A straight shot with Reapers trying to crush us along the way.
We just need to get a handful of troops through.
Only a handful, huh?
We knew this was going to be a gamble at best.
Can't think of anyone else I'd rather do this with.
Nobody does it alone.
We're in sight of the target.
All right, everyone. This is it.
Come on!
Don't argue with me, Ash.
Damn it, I can do this.
I know you can. No matter what happens here today, I'm always there.
And while we still have many challenges ahead of us, we can face them together.